Hello to all. We will solve exercise 1.1 by NCERT. Okay, by NCERT. And the first question. Before that, one video has been gone by related to this chapter about introduction. Okay. See, first question is given using appropriate properties. Find first is here and second is here. We have to find the value of this question. This value. Let's see here. Here is given minus 2 upon 3 in 3 by 5 plus 5.2 minus 3.5 into 1 by 6. First of all, we recognize here how can this transfer to the one to the next. Here is 3 by 5 and here is also 3.5. This both term is next to each other like this. And this is called as associative property. Associative property. Minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 and this will transfer to the next minus 3 upon 5 into 1 by 6 and this is 5 by 5. This one is here. Now, using the distributive property, which property? Distributive property. Take the common from here. The common is 3 upon 5. 3 upon 5. Using one bracket, remaining here minus 2 by 3. And here is remaining minus 1 by 6. And this is as it is 5 upon 3. Now solve this. This is 3 upon 5. And 3 and 6, the sum of 3 and 6 is 6. And this will become minus 4. And this is minus 1 plus 5 upon 3. 5 upon 3. Now, 3 upon 5 into this will become minus 5 by 6 plus 5 by 2. I think there is no doubt up to here. Okay, next. This 5 is cut with this in minus 1 time. 3 1 jar. 3. 3 1 jar. 3. Sorry. Here it can be also put 3 1 jar and 3 2 jar. 1 1 jar. 1. 1 1 jar. 1. And here 2 1 jar. 2. And minus, then here minus. And this is plus 5 by 2. Plus 5 by 2. As it means 2 minus 1 plus 5. So 4 by 2 and 4 by 2 cut it by 2 times. Okay, first answer is 2. Next, again, from here, see here, 2 by 5 is also here, 2 by 5 also here. So, this will transfer to the here, like 2 by 5 into minus 3 by 7, and this transfer to the next plus 1 by 14 into 2 upon 5, into 2 upon 5. And this remaining is retained after this, that 1 by 6 into 3 by 2, into 3 by 2. Then, take the common from this board, and the common is 2.5 is also 2.5. 2.5 is common, and in bracket remaining minus 3 by 7, and plus 1 upon 14, and minus. This can be solved, 3 1 and 3 2. Okay? 1 1 jar, 1 and 2 2 jar, 4. 2 2 jar, 4. Solve this. 2 upon 5. As well, 7 and 14 is 14. And this is minus 6 plus 1. Minus 1 upon 4. Here, 2 upon 5 into this can be written as minus 5 by 14. Minus 6 plus 1 minus 5 and 14 is here. And this is minus 1 upon 4. Minus 1 upon 4. Here 5 1 jar and 5 this one is minus 5. 2 1 jar and 2 7. See here 1 1 jar. 1. 1 1 jar 1 and 1 7 jar 7. And minus 2 plus minus. And this is also minus 1 upon 4. S of 74 is 28 and this is minus minus 11 by 20. This is the answer of second question of subtraction. Okay?
Now, next question, second is given that write the additive inverse of the each of the following. We have to write the additive inverse. What is the additive inverse?
What is additive inverse? Additive inverse is if there is a quantity that is x, if there is quantity that is x, then the additive inverse is minus x. And the quantity is minus x, then the additive inverse is plus x. It means additive inverse are those numbers which can be added, the result is 0.
It means when additive inverse are added to each other, the result is 0. Okay? And the simplification, simplify, we can write by using minus symbol or plus symbol. Just change the sign. If there is plus, answer is minus. If there is minus, the answer is
plus. So see here, question is given that additive inverse of 2 upon 8. Question number second. First, second, third, fourth, and fifth. First is given 2 upon 8. Second is minus 5 upon 9. Third is minus 6 upon minus 5. Fourth is 2 upon minus 9. And next is 19 upon minus 6. Okay? See, that's additive inverse. Additive inverse. Here is 2 upon 8 is in the plus. So answer is minus. Minus 2 upon 8. Here, additive inverse. This is in minus. The answer is in plus, that is 5 upon 9. Next, minus 6 upon 5 can be written as 6 upon 5. Minus and minus cancel. So additive inverse is minus 6 upon 5. 2 upon minus 9. So additive inverse is 2 upon 9. 19 upon minus 6. So additive inverse is 19 upon 6. Here your answer or the question number second. It is very easy. Find the additive inverse.
Okay. Third, verify that minus x equal minus in bracket minus x equal plus x. We have to verify that.
Let's see here. We have to verify that minus in bracket minus x is x. And the value of x is given as first value is this 11 upon 50. And the second value of x is given minus 30 upon 70. It means right hand side is given and we have to verify left hand side. The left hand side. So here minus in bracket minus x. So right here minus again in one bracket minus and value of x is 11 upon 50. Now minus into minus plus 11 upon 50. So here minus 11 upon 50 is equal to minus in bracket minus 11 upon 50. It means x is equal to minus in bracket minus x, very fine. Okay, second, here is given the minus and value of x is in minus. So we have to verify minus in bracket minus x. Good. Value of minus is minus. See here carefully. Minus, minus. Again, a large bracket you use here, minus, minus. Now the value of x is minus 13 upon 17. Now close large bracket and small bracket. First of all, we break here the small bracket, that minus into minus. Minus into minus plus 13 upon 17. And now break the large bracket, that here is plus and here is minus. So value is minus 13 upon 17. So we can write minus 13 upon 17 is equal to minus in large minus minus 13 upon 17. So we can see here x is equal to minus minus x, very high. Okay, this is the question number third of exercise 1.1. Now the fourth question, find the multiplicative inverse of the following. What is the multiplicative inverse?
multiplicative inverse are those numbers when it multiplied by the number, its answer is 1. It means when the both numbers are multiplied to each other, the answer is always equal to 1. Okay? See here, multiplicative inverse, question number 4 of the exercise 1.1. Multiplicative inverse we have to find it. Let's see here, first example, what is the multiplicative inverse? If we take any example that is all we have four a number and we have to find the multiplicative inverse. 4 can be written as 4 upon 1. 4 can be written as 4 upon 1 and this is known as numerator and this is known as denominator. Just reciprocally, then it means 4 upon 4 and this is the multiplicative inverse of this. If there is a fraction also, already given the fraction, just like 3 upon 5. Given that 3 upon 5 and we have to find the multiplicative inverse of 3 upon 5. Just reciprocally, that is 5 upon 3 and this is the multiplicative inverse. One thing always remember, there is no sign change in the multiplicative inverse. Additive inverse just change the sign and multiplicative inverse just denominator into numerator and numerator into denominator. That's why we can find the multiplicative inverse. Okay, I hope you understand this. Let's see here. Here is given 13 can be written as minus 13 can be written as minus 13 upon 1 and just reciprocally this is 1 upon minus 13. 1 upon minus 13 and this is your answer. Here is minus 13 upon 19. So 19 upon minus 13. This is 1 upon 5 can be written as 5 upon 1, 5. Here it is. First of all, solve it. Solve 5 3 15 and 7 8 are 56 minus 8 minus 8. This is the answer of this given number. 15 upon 56. So the multiplicative inverse is 56 upon 15. 56 upon 15. Now see here. First of all, multiply it. Minus 2 upon 5 minus 8 minus plus. Reciprocal is equal to 5 upon 2. And 1 minus 1 is given. Minus 1 minus. Okay? This is the answer of question number 4. Exercise 1.1. Multiplicative inverse. Very easy. Just numerator into denominator and denominator into numerator. Okay? Now the fifth question is given that name the property under multiplication used in each of the following. We have to say which property is here. कौन सी property यहाँ पे है?
See here, question number 5, we have to find which identity is used in the question number 1st, 2nd and 3rd. ठीक है? Okay, let's see here. Everywhere one is used here. So, अब यहाँ, here, one is used in the first question. So, one is multiplicative identity.
It means, multiplicative identity means
the value of the number or fraction or anything that not change. See here, minus 4 upon 5 into 1. It also answer is minus 4 upon 5. And when 1 multiplied to this, the answer is also this. So here can be written as 1 which is used is multiplicative identity. Because 1 is used in the first section. Now here, second question is given. Minus 13 upon 17 into minus 2 upon 7 equal minus 2 upon 7 into minus 13 upon 7. What is here? Here is simple. If we let A into, and this is also B equal B into A, and this property is known as commutative property. This property commutative property. Commutative property. Second, third is here. Minus 19 upon 29 into 29 into minus 1, minus 19. See here, if this is A upon B, so this is B upon A, just reciprocal.
Just reciprocal.
And the value of reciprocal is known as?
Just the last question. Is multiplicative inverse.
Okay, this is question number 5.
Question number 5. See, question number 6 is given that multiply 6 by 13 by the reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16.
That is, first of all, we have to find here reciprocal. Reciprocal of minus 7 upon 16 equal to what is the reciprocal? Just opposite, this denominator become numerator and this numerator become denominator. Okay, what is the answer? 16 upon minus 7,
and we multiply 6 upon 13.
Now 6 upon 13 multiply by this, because this is the reciprocal. 16 upon minus 16 upon minus 7.
Any doubt?
Okay. There is no nothing number can be reduced. So multiply that. 16 6 is 96 and 37 is 94 minus. Minus can be written in the numerator, that is minus 96 upon 91 can be minus 1 5 upon 90. Your answer here. Question number
6. Answer of question number 6. Now, see the question number 7. Question number 7. Just tell the property. Tell what property allows to compute 1 upon 3 into in bracket 6 into minus 4, sorry, 6 into 4 upon 3 as 1 upon 3 into 6 into 4 upon 3. See here, it is very easy, master.
Given that 1 upon 3 in bracket 6 into 4 upon 3. If you let this is A, this is B, and this is C. If you let it,
then it
suppose that 1 upon 3 is equal to A, 6 is equal to B, and 4 upon 3 is written as C. And the next is given 1 upon 3 into 6 in bracket into 4 upon 3. 4 upon 3. And this is 1 upon 3 we get here as A. And this is as B. And this is as C. Just the bracket move from here to there.
And this property is known as, this property is known as associative property.
This property? Associative property. What is associative property? Well, A into B into C, if you let here, A into B into C, it is also to A into B into C. This is associative property. So the answer is associative property.
Next, question number 8. Is 8 by 9 the multiplicative inverse of minus 1, 1 upon 8? Why or why not? Okay.
See here, in question number 8, here two fractions are given, 8 upon 9 and minus 1 over upon 8. This is the simple fraction, we convert this also in the simple fraction. 8 over 8 upon 9 upon 8 is minus. Okay, first of all, this is not a multiplicative inverse, no. This is, sorry, minus 1, 1 upon 8 is not a multiplicative inverse of 8 upon 9. Okay, we write the sentence and here it asks why. Why it is not a multiplicative inverse? So, when the multiplicative inverse are multiplied to each other, the answer is always 1. It means 8 upon 9 when multiplied by minus 9 upon 8, answer is always 1. But here is 8, 1. This guy's answer is minus 1. So, because the answer is, the multiplication is, the multiplication is not 1. What is not? Here is answer is minus 1. So it is not a multiplicative inverse. Okay. Now question number 9.
Question number 9 is same as question number 8. So it is for homework to you. Now question number 10. See question number 10. Write the rational number that does not have reciprocal. Any rational number which have not any reciprocal. So the this number does not have the reciprocal.
Just zero.
Zero has no reciprocal. The second question is given that the rational number that are equal to their reciprocal. The rational number that is equal to, this is question number 10.
Second,
we have to find the rational number that are equal to their reciprocal.
This is one because one can be taken as 1 upon 1 and also is 1 upon 1. See, the number and the reciprocal both are same.
So, one is the same as their
reciprocal. This is the second answer.
Third is asking that the rational number that is equal to its negative. The rational number which is equal to its negative. So, it is also 0.
It is also 0 because minus 0 or plus 0 equal to each other. But minus 1 and plus 1 not equal to here. The difference is 2, but here is no difference.
Okay, I think up to question number 10, you can understand. See question number 11. 0 has, fill in the blanks, 0 has no reciprocal. 0 has no reciprocal. Just ask in the 10th question number first. Second is, the number has their own reciprocal. Which numbers have their own reciprocal? So there are two only numbers, that is 1 and minus 1. Third is given, the reciprocal of minus 5 is minus 1 upon 5, or you can write also 1 upon minus 5. Reciprocal of 1 upon x, where x is not equal to 0 is, reciprocal of 1 upon x is x, just denominator become numerator. Fifth, the product of two rational number is always, the product of two rational number is always the rational number. The reciprocal of positive rational number, the reciprocal of positive rational number is always positive, and the reciprocal of the negative number is always negative. So thank you. Exercise 1.1 finished here. In the next lecture, we solve exercise 1.2. I think in the 1.2, we'll learn here about the number line and the rational number between two.